We're here with Nadia again, and we're going to talk about the stages of design sprint. But let's first of all talk about what is a design sprint.
Well, that's a great question. Design sprints started at Google about 5 years ago, and since then have become a powerful movement that helps product teams at Google, our developers, and companies in the industry solve design problems quickly.
And what are the stages of a design sprint?
So a design sprint always starts in the planning stage. That's potentially the most important one. The design sprint is run by a person called a sprint master. We found that sprints that have a designated person who is in charge of the event and in charge of the team lead to much higher satisfaction and to much higher deliverables. So we always want to have a point person who is organizing. This could be the PM on your team, or this could be your CEO, this could be the designer, or it could be you, regardless of whatever role you play. The role of the sprint master is first to identify the challenge that the team should be solving. If that is not clear, it's very hard for anyone to make progress. Second, the role of the sprint master is to assemble the team. We want to invite all the right talent, and that's the most important part. If you don't have a team, the sprint doesn't really happen. One of the benefits of the sprints is that you don't always have all the talent that you want, but you can get them. Because the sprints are short, you can invite people who are not from your team. So for example, if you and I were running a sprint and we didn't have a designer or a researcher, we could ask one of our colleagues who is in another team or another company to join us for 2 to 5 days. No one wakes up in the morning hoping to have a boring day. And when you invite them on a sprint, they usually say yes, and they have fun, and they help you solve something quickly and really benefit your team.
And what are the next stages after planning?
Okay, so the design sprint framework is based on understanding of design thinking. So anyone who is a designer might find these things familiar and very comfortable to practice. The good news is that if you've never practiced design, this is very, very easy to learn. Generally, there's 6 problem-solving stages of design sprints. The first is defining the challenge. You have to do that. Once you've done with that, you start 6 problem-solving ways of attacking this challenge. The first is to understand. Understanding a challenge is very, very important. There's a great quote that I love that says, "First, seek to understand, and then to be understood." Many teams fail because they start attacking their products based on the solutions that they have in their heads, and they do not understand the customer, the requirements, and technology that they have. So what we recommend in a sprint is to start with lightning talks. You quickly want to hear from everybody in the team that can represent a particular perspective, and generally the most useful are 3. First, you want to hear about the business goals. We believe that good design is good business, and we always invite the stakeholders of the business to tell us about their objectives. In a startup, that may be the CEO of the company, or it could be someone who is really in charge of revenue.
Right.
It's useful to have them there. They can bring a valuable perspective so that the designers are not running away from the goals of the company. Second, we want to hear from the engineers. Designers and engineers go together like peanut butter and jelly. You need them in the room. Because if the designers create something that the engineers cannot deliver, it sort of doesn't matter.
Right.
So the engineers are there to tell us what is feasible right now, what is the code able to achieve, and what are they able to do sort of within the parameters of the sprint. So this is it, business stakeholders, technology, what's missing? Well, you can create a startup, but you cannot create an audience if you don't have a perspective of the user. So what's really important is to bring a perspective that tells us who are the potential users of the product that we have. A lot of companies are not sure who their prospective user is. So it's useful to invite the first kind of ideas that you have about who might this be impacting. And if you're not sure, you can invite different groups. For example, if you're creating a news app, you can invite people who are news readers and who read the New York Times on paper, and people who love reading the newspapers on their iPad, and then people who don't read the news at all. And by learning what each group needs, you're able to tackle a quite broad set of users. By hearing their opinions in the beginning, reviewing user research that's relevant, and talking to users directly, the sprint becomes so much more well-informed, and the chances that they'll miss something are so much lower.
Very cool. So we talked about understanding, and we talked about planning before that. Mm-hmm. What is the next stage?
That's a great question. The design sprint moves in a series of intellectual motions that allows us to open our minds and then focus again. We believe that we shouldn't just jump to a solution, but we should learn as much as possible and then focus and narrow the best choices, and through that, we end up with better results. After the understand phase, which opens everybody's mind, we have another phase, which is about definition. That is a phase that helps the team understand what is the strategy they want to pursue. So, at this stage, we tend to look at the user journey that we want to take the user on. For example, if we're creating an onboarding flow, this may look at the major steps along the way of someone signing up for a new service. Or, if you're creating a new product, this may take you from all the stages that are key to someone learning about your product, discovering it, the first time they use it, the first time they return. And what we wish to everyone is that users become their master powerful evangelizers, where they're coming over and over to the product and they're really enjoying using it.